signaling support for those now in charge in Kyrgyzstan. A visiting U.S. diplomat promises Washington's help for the steps the interim government is taking to restore democracy.
The United States believes that the provisional government and the people of Kyrgyzstan have a unique and historic opportunity to create a democracy that could be a model for Central Asia and the wider region.
More than 80 people died here in the bloody uprising last week that ousted President Kurmanbek Bakiyev. Washington is now calling this a democratic transition. This implicit U.S. recognition comes just a day after Russia promised $50 million in aid. Both are now openly jostling to secure interests. The interim government has already promised to keep open this U.S. airbase in Manas, crucial for the NATO operation in Afghanistan, but a major sore point for Moscow, which considers former Soviet republics its own spheres of influence. But the new government also says Russia is its key ally.
The pro-Russian rhetoric of the interim government reflects the expectations of the people. Everyone wants Russia to help, especially economically.
Human rights activists fear closer ties with Russia may mean less political freedom in the long run.
Kyrgyzstan must choose the West and Western values, democracy, freedom of speech, and liberalism. The country will thrive if it lives according to these values. Russia is a totalitarian country.
Many experts agree this rivalry between Russia and the U.S. is likely to continue. But the two do have common interests here, like preventing the spread of Islamist groups in this largely moderate Muslim country, something that requires a commitment to eradicating poverty. And at the end of the day, Kyrgyzstan just doesn't have the luxury to choose. President Kurmanbek Bakiyev is now in neighboring Kazakhstan. This country, Kyrgyzstan, is now on the brink of radical changes internally, but externally it still faces the same dilemma, how to balance the interest of major powers in this region. Roza Ibragimova, Al Jazeera, Bishkek.